junior outside hitter from Burlington, Ontario, Canada, number 4, Maddie Saris. A 5'10 junior center from Fishers, Indiana, number 10, Cameron Hayter. A 6'2 sophomore opposite hitter from Solana Beach, California, number 13, Avery Tatum. A 6'3 senior middle blocker from Colleyville, Texas, number 15, Savannah Colby. A 6'2 graduate student middle blocker from Westerville, Ohio, number 18, Kaylee Rammelsberg. And the leader is a 5'7 freshman from Pendleton, Indiana, number 42, Ramsey Gary. The associate head coach is Rachel Morris. The assistant coaches are Kevin Hodge and Brett Hackney. And in year number 6 as head coach of the Indiana Hoosiers, please welcome back to Rec Hall, longtime Penn State assistant coach, Steve A.
On this roster to go along with veterans such as Allie Holland and Taylor Trammell, who are returning to the team.
Meanwhile, you look at Indiana, and they've had two really standout players being Cameron Hayworth and Maddie Saris. They've been outstanding so far this season. Hayworth, really a do-it-all player in that center position. Paces this team offensively, and then from the service line, she's one of the best in the country.
Yeah, I think when you look at the volleyball teams, a lot of the time you might look at the player with the most kills as the heart and soul of the offense, but for this Hoosiers team, it is Cameron Hayworth, the setter. Not only is she a fantastic facilitator, but also great as a server, as you mentioned, Matt. Leading the Big Ten in service aces per set with about 0.72, leading the Big Ten in service aces in total with 41 and also 561 assists on top of that to also lead the Big Ten conference. And you mentioned Maddie Saris, 839 career kills, potential to approach that 1,000 kill club, which would be the 20th member in Indiana history in that category, and also 144 kills on the season.
Then you look over at Penn State, it's up on the screen, Jess Merzick, Allie Holland. They've been outstanding this year. Merzick coming over from Michigan, trading in the maize and blue for the blue and white. And she's been not only one of the best players in the Big Ten, but one of the best players in the country.
Yeah, Jess Merzick, absolutely outstanding so far in her first season with the Nittany Lions. 195 kills to lead this Penn State team. Coming off a great performance last weekend against Minnesota in that win, 21 kills in that match. She's just been absolutely dominant, and you can see Allie Holland as well. A little bit different, not a transfer, actually a veteran of this team, one of the leaders of this program, 1.33 blocks per set, as you can see there.
And now we'll take a look at this Indiana starting lineup. At the outside, they have Candela Alonso-Corsalis along with Maddie Saris. Cameron Hayworth is that starting center, and in the middle they have Savannah Colheath and Kaylee Rammelsberg, along with Avery Tatum also getting the start tonight. And then at libero, they have Ramsey Gary. Meanwhile, for Penn State, Taylor Trammell, Mac Pedraza, Cameron Hanna, Angelina Stark, Jess Merzick, and Allie Holland with Jillian Grimes as the libero. There's Hayworth. She sets a go, and we're underway from rec hall between Penn State and Indiana. Merzick tries to get the offense going early. Her first swing sails long, and the Hoosiers up early.
And you can already see those two players that we highlighted right there. Cameron Hayworth, the great serve. Not a great dig by Grimes, but good swing by Merzick, just a little bit too far.
Hayworth, 41 service aces to 33 errors on the year. Here's Hanna looking to go cross court. And two missed swings gives Indiana the early lead. Hoosiers have struggled when it comes to playing in Happy Valley, looking for their first win all time inside rec hall. There you see that serve from Hayworth causing issues. And Maddie Saris, one of the players to watch, capitalizes on the overpass.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Matt, Jillian Grimes, a few times already struggling with that Hayworth serve. Just absolutely incredible. One of the best jump serves in the country.
That's Stark with the receive this time. Set to Merzick off the block, covered by the Hoosiers. That was at Avery Tatum. Now it's Hanna, and a tip at the net. Gives Penn State their first point of the night.
Cameron Hanna, another one of these transfers we talked about, coming over from Clemson in her first year here with the Nittany Lions. Led the team in kills versus Illinois last Friday. She's definitely a great player added to this Penn State team.
Double contact. Or hitting error, rather, against Indiana. Penn State comes a little closer here. Early stages.
I believe that was Maddie Saris going underhand on the ball there.
From the back row comes Candela Alonzo Corcellis. She's been outstanding this year, coming off an 8-kill performance against Nebraska in the Hoosiers' last match. Came in with 110 kills on the season. Maddie Saris is back to serve. Merzick rejected at the net. It's a double block. Kaylee Rammelsberg along with Avery Tatum. And Indiana throwing the first punches here. Sarah's still back to serve. And Indiana really starting to get their offense into gear and their defense. Penn State looking to respond. Head on the cross court. Tatum once again puts it home for Indiana.
Yeah, really strong start for the Hoosiers so far, leading this one 6-2 early in rec hall. We mentioned, Matt, this team never has won a match in this building. That's a great start so far in this one.
Plenty of talent on this Indiana team who has struggled in years past but had a productive 2022. Jess Merzick, free swing and converts.
I think that's what you got to do if you're at Penn State. You know, you start off a little bit slow, go to your best player, your best outside hitter, and let her just swing away.
Now some substitutions for both sides. Cassie Kirshen comes in. She'll go back to serve as Cameron Hanna comes out. And Gray Gosnell is in for the Hoosiers in the back row. There's Tatum again. Avery Tatum, the sophomore out of California, has really burst onto the scene here for Indiana. A couple of kills here in the early goings of set one. Centered up by Pedraza, read by Hayworth. Back set to Holland, and Hayworth's there once again. And there's Alonzo Corcellis. Corcellis, excuse me. Gets her second kill.
Yeah, Indiana offense already starting off strong. We saw Obviously, they took that 6-3 lead or 6-2 lead. Penn State got a point, but Indiana doing a great job maintaining that lead, not letting the Nittany Lions gain any momentum here early.
And Jess Merzik answers back off the block.
And Jess Merzik has been that one solution for the Nittany Lions so far. Two kills already on the day.
She's going back to serve, and if you want to get your offense into gear, she's the one to get you going. Alexa Markley comes into the front row in place of Angelina Stark. Down the middle, King and Colheed. Now it's Markley looking to go cross court. No touch at the net. To the dismay of this Penn State crowd.
Yeah, fans not happy with that one. Couldn't really tell from our perspective if it was touched. Maybe heard a little bit of a sound, but nevertheless, a point for the Hoosiers.
Merzik's pipe goes long. And Indiana with a 10-4 lead early, and that's going to prompt the timeout from Penn State head coach Katie Schumacher-Cawley. Hoosiers up early here in set one. We'll step aside for a quick break here on Big Ten Plus. At Rec Hall, and Jacob, we've talked about it. Indiana, their history against Penn State has not been great. 16-1 all time against Penn State, and 0-31 all time here at Rec Hall. They've got the early lead.
Yeah, it's been a tough struggle for Indiana all time against Penn State. You mentioned only one win in 61 total matchups, and none coming here at Rec Hall. But and last year, you know, these teams matched up again. Penn State, of course, coming away with that win, sweeping Indiana. But as you mentioned, Matt, great start up 10-4. Penn State not really able to get anything going so far. Just swinging a little bit too hard, a couple unforced errors, and Indiana looking for that potentially second win all time. And on a good start to getting their first win in Rec Hall in this first set.
You saw it on that graphic, last win and only win for Indiana, October 9th, 2010 in Bloomington. It's October 6th and they've got the early lead here in State College. And a timeout. Here's Allie Holland going cross court. Avery Tatum, who's had the hot hand, picks up the dig. And there's that blocking core for Penn State. Matt Podraza and Allie Holland electrifying this Rec Hall crowd.
Exactly what the Nittany Lions wanted. Coming out of that timeout, immediate points on the board. Allie Holland, a player that we highlighted pregame with those blocks, an incredible defensive player at that middle blocker position.
Penn State, one of the best blocking teams in the country, sixth nationally with 2.93 blocks per set. Holland's serve goes long. The lead's back up to six for Indiana.
Yeah, first service error on the day for either team, but Penn State, five attack errors also, just really been the difference so far early in this first set.
Candela Alonzo Corcellis back to serve. Taylor Trammell through the middle, it's kept up by Hayworth. Markley's hit, goes long, no touch either. And those hitting errors for Penn State. Starting to ramp up here. That's their sixth here in the first set alone, and the lead is up to seven for the Hoosiers. Beautifully set up there for Indiana as Alonzo Corsellis gets it done. Largest lead of the night for Indiana, and it keeps to grow. Here's Markley. And this time, Alexa Markley gets it done. A much-needed point and a much-needed offensive boost for this Penn State side as Cameron Hanna comes in for Cassie Kershaw.
And maybe a little bit of a lucky break there for the Nittany Lions. Not really sure if that was going to land inbounds on that Markley attack, but Issa Lopez going for the dig there, just could not control it, sent it all the way back out of play, and Penn State is back on the board.
Mac Pedraza back to serve for her. Causing some trouble. Free ball comes over from IU. Hannah going cross court.
Second kill of the day for Cameron Hannah. Her and Merzlik now tied for the team lead on the Nittany Lions. We're going to need more of these transfers to start stepping up. So down against the Hoosiers right now, 13-7.
Pedraza, the transfer from Ohio State. But here's IU on the other end with a response. It's Savannah Colheed, middle blocker on the slide.
Continuing that trend of just not allowing Penn State to really get consecutive points in a row and not really allowing them to get any momentum. Indiana playing some great defense and truly really staying on the attack on offense.
And across court, Hayworth with a diving save. Comes back over. Saris taps it over, and these two going back and forth. Hannah off bounce, barely able to get it over. And now on another slide, it's the other middle this time, and Ramelsburg.
Yeah, Hannah not happy with herself on that one. Kind of mistimed the jump and deflected it just out of bounds. Could see her displeasure.
Colheed back to serve. Hannah one more time. This time it goes through.
And she just gets it right back. Mentioned these transfers now. Cameron Hannah leading the team with those three kills. Merzlik right behind her with two. Coming over to Penn State from Clemson and Michigan respectively. These two outside hitters have been key for this Penn State offense and are going to be key here today if they want to get back from this 15-8 deficit.
Back in the front row, gets an early swing. And there's Taylor Trammell with a solo block. Trammell coming off a career night offensively in the match against Minnesota on Saturday. 16 kills, her career high. And there she gets the defense going. Hayworth on the setter dump, takes it herself. That's what makes her so dangerous.
And once again, that last Penn State point, another deflection out of play, that time by Maddie Saris. Penn State, a couple of their points here, really getting lucky from these Indiana players, just not really being able to handle the ball, making some unforced errors, and then, as you see, Cameron Hayworth just taking advantage on that last point.
There you see the risk-reward with Hayworth's serving style. She's been able to master it pretty much through her career, that high-velocity serve. Just not able to creep over the top of the tape. Penn State gets into double digits. Now Jillian Grimes with a service ace of her own. Penn State getting back little by little as this first set has moved along. Grimes a career high with service aces at Minnesota over the weekend. Four against the Golden Gophers. Nice dig from Merzlik off the block. Back set to Tatum, goes down the line.
That was just a massive swing by Avery Tatum. She's had an outstanding match so far. Now four kills. That one just blasted at Jillian Grimes, unable to handle it.
6-point lead for Indiana. 8 points away from taking the first set. There's Merzlik off the block. Through the middle, it's Ramelsburg. middle out of Westerville, Ohio, and Ramelsburg up to two kills. Sarah's serve is long.
And these errors here, not really a ton coming from the Hoosiers so far, but that's going to be the thing that I think gets Penn State back into this one, and the thing that Indiana needs to really clean up if they want to secure this first set victory. Those errors have really separated this first set so far. Penn State obviously having a lot more, but six attacking errors.
What a beautiful set off the net from Hayward, finding Ramelsburg. Penn State with no answer right now for this middle.
And already six different Hoosiers with kills compared to just three for Penn State. It's been a full team effort from Indiana to get this seven point lead so far.
Holland on the slide, and she's denied by Candela Alonzo Corcellis.
Alonzo Corcellis tied for the team lead with three kills today, and that would be her first block on the day. Indiana first team to 20 points in this first set.
Gary with the serve. Here's Merzik. A little extra emphasis behind this one. Picks up her third kill.
And targeting Ramsey Gary there of Indiana, leading the Big Ten in digs as just a freshman libero. She's been outstanding this season, but Merzik, the veteran, swing a little bit too powerful there for her to handle.
Allie Holland in the middle, meeting Savannah Colheed. That's Holland's second block in this first set.
And you mentioned it, Matt, no kills so far for Holland, but making an impact defensively with those two blocks.
Merzik in the back row with a nice up. Here's Markley on a roll shot. She gets it down.
Good job by Alexa Markley there. You know, Penn State struggled a little bit, just swinging as hard as possible, and they've lost control of their attacks a little bit. That time, just a soft touch to find the soft spot in that Indiana's defense.
A 3-0 run prompts a timeout by the Hoosiers. It's 20-15. Indiana as we'll step aside here in the first set. Back at Rec Hall, Indiana with an early first set lead up 20-15, and a big part of that is their head coach and Steve Aird in his sixth season at the helm of the Hoosiers, but a little bit of a homecoming for Aird. Penn State alum, 3 years an assistant coach to legendary coach Russ Rose, two national championships when he was on that Penn State staff.
Yeah, Aird also a two-year team captain in his time with the men's volleyball team. Great homecoming for him. His sixth season as head coach of this Hoosiers team. Also coached at Maryland prior to that. Really a true Big Ten coach and player through and through.
Has had some tough times in Indiana, but has started to get it going lately. 16-16 year last year with a 9-11 record in the Big Ten. And right now looking to get to that 3-3 mark, 4-2 mark. There's his overall record at Indiana, 73-92. He's got his team in a good spot here, 5 points away from taking set one, but Penn State surging on a 3-0 run currently. Merzik with a nice back row dig off the swing of Tatum.
Come on, girl.
There's Markley off the block, and it's out of bounds.
And Jillian Grimes kind of watched that one go out slowly, thought about going for it at first, saw that it was going out of bounds, and just stopped and waited. Good awareness by the sophomore.
Markley now tied with Hannah and Merzik. for a team high three kills. They're the only three with kills for Penn State, but Avery Tatum, not the only one within for Indiana with kills. She moves into a team high with her fourth.
And Tatum has just been absolutely unstoppable swinging away from that opposite side hitting position. Four kills on the day.
Markley off the block again. Tatum did not get it. And Markley now has her fourth kill.
Yeah, close call there. I thought she might have actually gotten her hand under that for the pancake dig, but ref says no. It's a Penn State point. Just a four-point lead now for the Hoosiers.
Allie Holland is back to serve. Penn State was down by as many as eight. Nice dig from Kirshen, floats back over. Another back set to Colheed. Mistimes the jump. Gives way to Markley once again. It's covered by Penn State and Kirshen. Nice rally. Blocked but covered by Ramsey Gary. And she's going to pick up the kill here. It just creeped over the net.
Yeah, unfortunate for Alexa Markley there, who came sliding in, kind of anticipated it, the ball to come over close to the net, but maybe wasn't expecting the bounce to come off the top right there, just mistimed it a bit. So the ball just falls right next to her for the Hoosiers point.
That was Issa Lopez that picked up the kill for the Hoosiers. A joust at the net. Tap back over to Indiana's side, and it's Colheed on the slide. Steve Aaron fired up for this Indiana team, and rightfully so.
Yeah, and that strategy has really been what's gotten Indiana this lead so far. Just these back sets from Hayworth right on this right side, and Penn State having no answers for it so far, leaving a huge hole right in the middle of their defense.
Merzik into the triple block. It's covered. She comes from the back row once again. Trammell just taps it over. Hayworth running in. Saris off the net and out of bounds. Indiana, 2 points here from picking up a set one win. This Indiana team took Nebraska to four sets at the end of September. Set to Markley. Lopez racing in off the block. Markley another time. Here's Saris. And Indiana's on set point.
This Indiana team is having an incredibly impressive first set. Just really clean volleyball all around. You know, hustling to the ball, great passes, not really many errors. Whether that be serving or attacking. And obviously those strong attacks have prevailed for this Hoosiers team, giving them this set point.
And that will end it. Saris taking advantage of the overpass. And Indiana strikes first here in first set. Takes it 25-18 over Penn State as we'll step aside here. And second set coming up. Hoosiers up early.
One, two, or three. Number two.
Your 14th-ranked Nittany Lions continue Big Ten Conference play tomorrow when they host the Ohio State Buckeyes. We continue our alumni weekend festivities as we honor the 15-year anniversary of our 2008 National Championship team. Join us for another match filled with memories and celebrations with program alumni. We will honor the 2008 National Championship team between sets 2 and 3 of tomorrow's match against Ohio State. First serve is slated for 6:30 p.m. Tickets are available now at www.ticketmaster.com/Penn State. We are on behalf of Penn State Women's Volleyball, we would like to welcome tonight's match the following groups. Governor Mifflin Volleyball.
Back at Rec Hall here, ahead of set number 2. Indiana taking set 1, 25-18 over Penn State. Matt Scalzo alongside Jacob Schnurr. And Jacob, that first set really saw a lot of cohesion from Indiana, not the same for Penn State.
Yeah, definitely a stunner in that first set, and that cohesion is really what sticks out. You know, a lot of clean passes, as I mentioned right before the break, towards the end of that first set, just really accurate passing all around, only 5 attacking errors for Indiana, just clean volleyball, while Penn State, 7 attacking errors, just not really looking as clean as they usually do. And, you know, this Indiana team, we talked a lot about it before, winless in Rec Hall, but taking a first set victory there are going to be big into potentially making history. Last time they even won a set here in this building was 2021.
So Penn State down a set here to Indiana. Looking to find their offensive mojo. Just kills from 3 players on this Penn State side. 4 from Alexa Markley and then 3 from Cameron Hanna and Jess Merzik. Taylor Trammell, after a career night against Minnesota, 0-4, and there's those stats you're looking at. That hitting percentage for Penn State's what stands out, 0-73 and then 3-08 for Indiana.
And the Hoosiers, 7 different players in the kill category, just a whole full team effort. Penn State only 3 players with kills today, that being Alexa Markley, Cameron Hanna, and Jess Merzik. Going to need a lot more contributions throughout the lineup if they want to come back in this one.
Teams will switch sides as we head into this second set. Indiana was up by as many as 8 early on in that first set, and that's what sparked them early on. Angelina Stark will get us going here in set number 2 from Rec Hall. Hayworth trying to take advantage on that aggressive center play, and it goes long as Penn State will take its first lead of the night. Merzik down the line, a diving save by Lopez. Ricochets off Alonzo Porcellis. Penn State striking fast, striking early here in set 2.
And already through just 2 points in the second set. Indiana looking a little bit messier than they had that entire first set.
There's that slide from Rammelsberg. And she doesn't get it to go this time. Angelina Stark continuing to serve, junior out of Colorado Springs, Colorado. Has really adjusted into the back row nicely. Here's Hanna off the block.
Talk a lot about that cohesion, Matt, you know, coming into the second set. Penn State off to a great start in that category, impacting this set, serving, attacking, and defensively with the blocks.
Hanna and Trammell combined to stonewall Saris. Now some trouble on that last swing. Hannah's blocked, covered by Stark. Hanna will get another try at it and puts it home. A complete shift of momentum here in set 2. Penn State the aggressor here, up 5-0. Steve Aird and Indiana taking a timeout. We'll step aside as well. It's 5-0 early in set 2 in favor of Penn State. at Rec Hall. Penn State up 5-0 early here in set number 2 over Indiana. The Hoosiers, through the first punch, taking set 1, 25-18. But Penn State, they've answered back here. They're getting their crowd behind them early. Matt Scalzo alongside Jacob Schnur. Jacob, what you've seen so far in set 2?
Yeah, you know, I mean, a real dominant showing for Indiana in that first set. We talked about the cohesion. Haven't seen it so much here yet in the second set. Penn State, however, really doing everything better than they did in that first set, fixing all their mistakes pretty much. As I mentioned, full team effort right now, doing it offensively, defensively, and in the service category.
Back row swing, and it's Candela, Alonzo, Corcellis. Putting it home for the Hoosiers, and their first point here in set number 2.
And just what Steve Aird ordered out of that timeout. Indiana coming right back, getting their first point of the set after quite a messy start. Need to find a little bit of that magic that they had in that first set if they want to get back in this one.
Here's Hannah, one-on-one, and gets it off the block of Saris.
Cameron had another player to spotlight really in this second set so far. Just been absolutely outstanding. 5 kills on the entire match.
There's that middle. Allie Holland touched on the open, averaging 1.33 blocks per set. She's got 3 total here as Penn State increases its lead up to 6. Swing down the line from Tatum. Just off the mark. Penn State continues to surge ahead here in set 2.
And also talked a lot about those attacking errors by Penn State in that first set that really made a big difference. No attacking errors for them so far. On the Hoosier side, however, 5 already. See just how much of an impact those mistakes can make on a score.
Another double block for Allie Holland in Penn State. Her 4th total tonight. And in her career against Indiana, she's done a pretty nice job, averaging 1.67 blocks per set and hitting over 300. And Cameron Hanna's the one that's got the hot hand offensively. Just with a little off speed, catches Tatum off guard.
Yeah, 6 kills in the match so far for Hannah. Transfer from Clemson. Led the team in kills versus Illinois just a week ago. There's something about Hannah on Fridays. Starts to click.
Penn State the first to double digits here. Here's Hannah once again. No stopping her.
She is really coming alive here in this second set. You know, I mentioned before, Penn State's going to need a little bit more of a team effort if they wanted to come back in the second set firing, but never mind that. It's the Cameron Hanna show, and it's working so far.
Serve from Grimes just off the mark. Grimes looking over at head coach Katie Schumacher-Colley. She thought she got it in. Saris is back to serve for Indiana. Just clips off the net, and that one's down for an ace.
Yeah, just the first service ace of the day there for the Hoosiers. Talked a lot about how Cameron Hayworth is an absolute master in that category. None yet for her today, but Saris impacting this game from that server's position.
Nice dig in the back row by Stark, and Grimes with the quick reactions. And a poor pass on Indiana's side. Gives Penn State the point. Great defensive job by Stark and Grimes.
Yeah, unbelievable job by Grimes there. That quick reaction, like you mentioned, Matt. Able to quickly get our hands up, set it over. Nice soft pass, able to keep that Penn State offense clicking.
And Cameron Hanna is back to serve. Leads the team with 7 kills. Marisic and Markley just behind with 4. And a cross court kill for Avery Tatum, just off the arm of Hanna. And she'll check out as Cassie Kershian will come in.
Yeah, and that play there looking a lot more like that first set where the Hoosiers were just feeding Avery Tatum on that opposite side. She would swing towards the opposite corner. Worked out quite often there in the first set. Trying it out again here, and it's worked in the previous play.
Talked a lot about the transfer. Cameron Hanna and Jess Merzik said, don't forget about me. She's up to 5 kills. 2-time Big Ten Player of the Week so far for her and her Penn State career. Had one during her time with Michigan. And an illegal block against Indiana as Holland went for the swing. Penn State up by 10. And forth here. Off the block, it's Alonzo Corcellis with another kill. That's her 5th, evening a team high with Avery Tatum.
Yeah, the two of them have really been absolutely outstanding offensively so far for the Hoosiers. You mentioned tied with 5 kills apiece. Truly clicking so far. Gonna need more of that. Gotta play through your star players a little bit more. But feed that hot hand. Indiana wants to get back in this one. So far, it's worked for Penn State. They've been feeding Cameron Hanna, feeding Jess Merzik. Indiana might need to take a little bit of a hint from their opponent.
Markley with a nice defensive play on the scrambling Hoosiers send a free ball. Markley again. You mentioned 2 hot hands. You didn't mention Alexa Markley. I think she might have heard you there, Jacob.
She is tied now for 2nd with kills. Alexa Markley has been absolutely outstanding as well.
Just in her sophomore season, coming off an All-Big Ten freshman season last year. That one catches back line off the swing from Colheed. There's Alonzo Corcellis with the serve. Kirshen in the back row. Here comes Merzik right down the line. Gary with a nice dig. Off the block, it's Grimes flying in. Great rally between these two. Merzik floats it over, some confusion. Markley again. And a net violation against Indiana.
Indiana finally getting something going there. Really good rally from both of these programs, but just another unforced error, and that's kind of been the story of the second set.
We got a timeout on the floor here as Penn State controlling here in set 2, up 16-6. We'll step aside quickly here on Big Ten Plus.
Hosted by Peacock.
The team's veteran leader earned the third ever individual title for the Nittany Lions in the men's collegiate golf 8K race. Women's volleyball, Matt Quadrata did a little bit of everything.
Back at Rec Hall, Penn State up here in set two. Katie Schumacher-Colley looking to keep the good vibes going here and even it up one apiece. Jacob, in just her second season, she's done such a great job, had such a great year last year, and you look at her just career here, even as a player and now here as a head coach.
Yeah, an unbelievable resume for Schumacher-Colley. You mentioned her rookie season last year, taking this team to a 26-8 record, going all the way to the NCAA tournament. Now this year off to a great start, 10-3. Only four games so far in Big Ten play, 4-0 in those conference games, or conference matchups, excuse me. It's really been the key for this Penn State team, those Big Ten matches.
Serve from Pedraza is long out of the timeout.
Number
36-11 for Schumacher-Colley through her year and a half so far with Penn State. This is just her second season. Spent 4 years as an assistant before taking over the helm for legendary head coach Russ Rose. As Cameron Hanna continues to produce offensively for Penn State, now up to 8 kills. And just one attacking error for her, a 467 clip. Offensively, but defensively as well for Cameron Hanna. She combines with Taylor Trammell for the double block there as Penn State is up by 11.
Yeah, 8 total kills for Hanna, but also those 4 blocks in that stat sheet. I think a little bit overlooked maybe, but she's definitely been doing it on both ends, making a huge impact, especially in the second set.
Stark had a nice dig before. Pedraza the same this time. Merzick's roll shot just a little wide.
A little bit off balance attack there. Didn't really get a good look over the net. Just swung it sidearm. Ended up being an inaccurate attack going out of play.
There's Taylor Trammell through the middle. Her first kill of the night. She's done a great job defensively so far. 3 total blocks for her. It's going to be hard for her to follow up the career night she had against Minnesota.
Yeah, definitely. And Trammell now the 5th Nittany Lion in the kill column. Entering this set, Penn State only had 3. Now Allie Holland and Taylor Trammell, the 2 middle blockers for the Nittany Lions team, added to their stat line.
There's Mercer going cross court. It's been all Penn State in this second set. They're the first to 20. And they're well within command here. Trying to show that first set was maybe just a fluke.
And quite the bounce back, not even reaching 20 points in that first set loss. Now getting 20 before Indiana can even get 10.
Merzick again. Great back set from Jillian Grimes. Tatum off the mark. Indiana went back to that slide that had given them so many points there in set one. Haven't had the same success here in set two as Penn State moves 3 points away. The overpass.
Just goes to show, you know, how different each set can be in a volleyball match. Obviously that first one, Indiana taking it commandingly 25-18. Now Penn State looking absolutely dominant in this second set. It's kind of that, you know, Ted Lasso mentality, the goldfish mentality. You gotta forget about what just happened, move on to the next. Penn State has done that so far.
Memory of a the Goldfish. They've certainly had it here as they move to set point here, up 24-8. 6-0 run. Grimes with the serve. Now extend a little bit further as Avery Tatum stops the Indiana drought. Maddie Saris back to serve here for the Hoosiers. As Brett Call reaches fever point. Holland wasn't able to find contact. Merzick, nice job backing it up. And now the two combined to end set two. A double block for Merzick and Holland. And Penn State dominates Indiana here in set two, 25-9.
Five total blocks for Allie Holland. Didn't quite get over there. I think that was just Merzick. Her first block of the day gets the set ceiling point there. Transfer continuing her outstanding effort. Eight total kills, tied for the team lead.
Penn State domination there in set two. Back to all square, one set apiece. Set three on the way here from Rhett Call. Penn State welcoming back its alumni here this weekend, and there's man, the legend, Russ Rose, longtime head coach. They were honoring the 2013 championship team. And another long list of alumni there. You see all the NCAA championships, and that 109 match win streak from 2007 to 2010, simply unheard of.
And a 35-2 record in that 2013 season. Just absolutely incredible stuff from the legend Russ Rose, like you mentioned. Great to honor this team one of the best that Penn State has ever seen. And Penn State volleyball has been a historic program a lot, and thanks to those three people, those two players, and the head coach there who just came out on the court.
Now we'll take a look at the match stats here through two sets, and the hitting percentages very different from what we saw in that second set. Indiana hit in the negatives, and Penn State was up above 500, nearly at 600, and that's where you see overall on the match for the two.
And those 8 blocks to just 2 for Indiana have been huge for the Nittany Lions on that defensive end. Also, the service ace is just 1-1. We talked a lot pregame about Cameron Hayworth and her impact as a server. Hasn't done anything in that category just yet. It'll be interesting to see if in this third set she can start to get that going.
And Penn State, a big reason for their hitting percentage. We touched on the main three. There's Cameron Hanna at the bottom. You see her 8 kills, 4 blocks, 467 hitting percentage. Jess Merzik also at 8 kills. Alex Markley with 6. Matt Podraza slowly put together another outstanding night at the center position for her. An exciting matchup on paper when you looked at the two setters in Hayworth and Podraza.
And on the Indiana side, Avery Tatum leading the Hoosiers with 6 kills on the day. Candela Alonso-Corcellis. Sorry, Matt.
Didn't mean to cut you off there.
Alonzo Corcells also 5 kills on 15 total attacks, and Maddie Saris. Saris, Cole Heed, and Rammelsberg, all 3 kills. So talked a little bit earlier about how this has been a full team effort from the Hoosiers, a lot of different players with kills. That second set didn't quite get anything going. See if they can find some of that magic they had in that opening set here in set number 3.
All getting pumped up here as basically back to square one. 1 set apiece. Both sides looking for 2 more. As Cameron Hayworth will begin set number 3 here for Indiana. And Cameron Hanna picks up right where she left off. Starts off set 3 with another kill.
And you know, through those first 2 sets, no lead changes at any point, no ties. So whoever got that first point really just stayed in control for the entire set. 1 point here to Penn State. We'll see if the Tides can turn in that category.
There's Tatum going cross court. Nice dig of back row by Stark. And it's Cameron Hanna. Cameron Hanna once again. Up to 10 kills. First player on either side to reach that double-digit mark.
Yeah, who else but Hanna hitting those 10 kills. Really picking up right where she left off in that dominant second set.
They're going to go to her again. The off-speed keeps it going and alive for Indiana. But that double block, hard to get through. Allie Holland, she's done it all night long. Cameron Hanna as well, getting involved defensively.
Yeah, Holland only 1 kill in the stat sheet, but those 6 blocks, huge impact from her on the defensive end. Once again.
Here from the back row, it's Holland once again. Are you not entertained? Allie Holland, a solo block and a quick timeout for Indiana here in set 3. Four to nothing, Penn State up. We'll step aside here on Big Ten Plus. Back at Rec Hall at Penn State, up 4-0 here in set number 3. You take a look here at these Big Ten standings overall. 3 teams undefeated at the top. It's the top 2 teams in the country in Wisconsin and Nebraska. And then the third are these Penn State Nittany Lions, ranked number 14 in the country.
And You see right behind them Michigan State, Purdue, Maryland, and then Indiana, that 2-2 record. Tied with Maryland, Minnesota, who just lost to Penn State last weekend. Ohio State there, and Illinois as well, who Penn State just took down. This Big Ten is a great conference and one of the best in women's volleyball at the collegiate level. Sydney Lions team, generally outstanding. Last year, 13-7 in the Big Ten. Katie Schumacher-Cawley off to an even more impressive start in conference play with that 4-0 record.
They welcome number 24, Ohio State, to rec hall tomorrow night. As out of the timeout, it's Kaylee Rammelsberg in Indiana's first point here in the third set.
It happened again. It happened in the second set as well. Penn State off to a 5-0 start in that one. Indiana calls a timeout, comes out with an immediate point. They do it again here with that 4-point deficit. See if they can follow up and gain some momentum.
Service error for Indiana. This rec hall crowd is loving what they've been seeing over the last set. 6 points so far as Cassie Kirshen is in. Back set to Tatum. Another solo block. This time it's Merzick.
And Merzick finishing off set number two with a block to end that one and give Penn State the win in that set. Now comes out with her second block of the afternoon, or the evening, excuse me.
Pedraza, the setter dump. Get all Penn State over the last two sets, flexing their muscles once again.
Indiana just not quick reaction time enough there to get the dig. Matt, I saw you trying to get that reaction going, almost trying to catch the ball there. Looked like it was coming right towards us.
It did take a bounce. Had got to keep your head on a swivel here. That rec hall, never know when ball might be coming towards you here down on the court. Indiana picks up a point there on another kill from Rammelsberg. Holland is blocked. Stark racing back, a huge save. Tatum once again, and there is no bringing this one back. Kirshen was there, but the ricochet sent that almost up near the lights and then right by the wrecking crew at Penn State student section. She rose deep.
And Tatum has really been automatic when she gets a clean look like that, catching Penn State out of system. No one really at the net to give her a quality block attempt. And Tatum just showing off that incredibly powerful swing. It's another kill right there.
Switched up with an off speed. Back to back kills for her. She's up to 8 total. Merzick can't find the line. Indiana with a nice quick run of their own, a 4-0 run. Brings up within 2.
An error there for Penn State, you know, something we haven't seen really since that first set. Only their second error on the second attacking error, since that first set. Playing really clean volleyball for the most part. Indiana the opposite. Only 5 attacking errors in that first set. Now they're up to 18 for these last two. Starting to put something together a little bit here, keeping it fairly close in set number 3.
Had a chance to bring it within 1 on the overpass. And they'll bring it within 2 once again. That was Colheed picking up the kill. Her 4th kill tonight. Some trouble on the back end here for Penn State. Markley comes through. And Alonzo Corcellis gets it through the double block of Pedraza and Holland. And Indiana surging here in the
Yeah, that rally just starting off a little bit messy for the Nittany Lions. Cassie Kirshen expected to go for the bump, but instead late last second switches to a set. Kind of sent Penn State out of rhythm. Indiana able to capitalize.
And Alonzo Corcellus, her swing goes into the antenna. Attacking error gives the point to Penn State.
I mentioned earlier, no lead changes or ties so far in this entire match. Indiana had a chance there to tie it up, didn't capitalize, but still just a two-point set, keeping it as close as this match has been.
Colhey blocked, covered by Indiana. A joust at the net, comes back to the Penn State side. Floated over, Trammell tries to capitalize, Gosnell is there. Another block, Lopez a diving save, it's Hayworth this time!
What a swing by Hayworth there. I thought she was gonna do that earlier in that rally. Went for the back pass, or back set, excuse me, instead. Then swung two times back to back there. She got a big swing for a setter.
It's not your prototypical setter dump. It's a true swing by Hayworth. And Steve Aird, he was pumped up after that last point. Penn State, numerous chances. Had that Indiana side scrambling and just weren't able to take advantage and set up their offense. As Alonzo Corcellus is back to serve for the Hoosiers. There's Trammell through the middle. She thought she was going to get a kill in that last rally and gets it this time on a tic-tac-toe play for Penn State.
Good job by Trammell. We talked a lot about her last weekend against Minnesota, getting a career-high 16 kills. Not making quite the same impact today with just two, but she's still been swinging away eight total attacks. Good to see her back after suffering that season-ending injury last season. She's having a really impressive 2023 so far.
Back set to Hannah. Blocked. She does it again. Lopez comes flying in, and it's Maddie Saris on the other end for Indiana. Bring
them within one. A great play there by Issa Lopez, just kind of going airborne for a second there to make that dig. Good, accurate, soft pass. Able to work out for the Hoosiers. They once again are within one.
Serving substitution here for Indiana as Kenzie Daphne is in. She comes in primarily to serve, and she's done a great job of it so far this season. Lines up straight down the middle in that row. Merzik with the pipe from the back row.
The first time we've called her name in the kill category so far in this third set. A big swing there. We're going to need more of her if Penn State wants to pull away. On the other end, you know, Hoosiers trying to keep it close and have to contain a player like Jess Merzik. And also Cameron Hanna, who, as well, hasn't really gotten a kill in quite some time.
That's Merzik once again. She was back by the 10-foot line on that swing. And just catches a little ricochet on its way to the Indiana side. She's now tied with Hannah with 10 kills. Jess Merzik coming alive here over the last 3 points.
After that first kill, I mentioned we hadn't really talked about her too much in the second set, and then all of a sudden, bursting onto the scene, you mentioned that 3 straight points for her. Now a 4-point lead for Penn State in this third set.
Again, she finds the corner. 4 straight points for Jess Merzik. 3 kills and a solo block mixed in between. through the middle. Merzik's there along with Trammell. It's covered by Indiana. Merzik again, a nice one-arm save by Lopez. Free ball from Indiana. Everyone knows where Podraz is going, but there's no stopping Jess Merzik. And it's another timeout for Indiana. A 5-0 Penn State run. They're up 15-9. Here in set three. Set three, Penn State starting to pull away a 5-0 run here on Big Ten Plus. Matt Scalzo alongside Jacob Schnur. Jess Merzik, she's been outstanding. Last 5 points have all come from her. She's got 12 kills along with 10 digs. It's the third straight match for her with a double-double.
Yeah, it's Merzik mania so far in Red Call in this third set. She's been absolutely outstanding. Took over the team lead, now 12 kills. So those 10 digs you mentioned, 3 blocks as well, 25 attacks. She has been swinging away this entire third set. Will give Penn State their biggest lead of set number 3.
They jumped out early in set 2. Cruised to a 25-9 win in set 2. Indiana battled back from an early 6-point advantage for Penn State. And the Nittany Lions and Jess Merzik have come alive here. Stark with a nice dig in the back row. Here's Hannah on the other end, and it's a solo block from Maddie Saris.
Nittany Lions done a pretty good job to combat that little set piece there by the Hoosiers where the pass to Hayworth and the back set to Rammelsberg. Jumping off 1 foot, swinging, but that time, just a great defensive play by Saris, able to combat the Cameron Hanna attack.
Pedraza went back to Hanna again. It was a little bit of an awkward attack. Hanna's going to want to have that one back. Indiana picks up 2 quick points out of the timeout. Kotrasa goes back to the hot hand to Jess Merzik, and she's got another kill, her 13th.
Indiana, no answers for Jess Merzik so far in this third set. Now up to 13 total kills.
That one just lightly tapped over by Rammelsberg, not by design. I think she was looking for more contact in. Just able to get a fingertip on it.
Really the first off pass we've seen from Hayworth. It was a little bit too high. Wasn't timed quite right with Rammelsberg's leaping attack. But nevertheless, works out for the Hoosiers. They get their 12th point.
Serve from Gosnell. Did not go how she had planned. Goes right into her teammate in Avery Tatum. Penn State up 17-12 here.
Yeah, Gosnell not super confident in that toss there. You saw she threw it up in the air, kind of hesitated for a second, swung anyway, and ended up right into the back of Avery Tatum.
Indiana answers back as Rammelsberg puts it down through the middle. Penn State looking to close it out here in set number 3, 8 points away. Here's Merzik, that sails long. And Indiana creeps a little closer. Merzik in every match this season but one has recorded double-digit kills, and that only one was against Colgate, where she only played two sets. They go back to her here. And why not? There's been no answer for Jess Merzik here in this third set.
We've seen her target Ramsey Gary quite a few times. Mentioned earlier, leading the Big Ten in digs this season is just a freshman, but only four digs on the day today, and a couple of kills for Penn State have gone right at her feet.
Merzik is back to serve here for Penn State. Holland just tries to tap it over as all of Indiana was creeped up towards the front of the net. And it sails long.
Yeah, it almost worked out. Good awareness by Holland to recognize that all the Hoosiers were pushed up against the net, leaving a lot of open space in the back. Just couldn't quite place it where it needed to be.
There's Holland going cross court. Nice dig in the back row by Merzik. Markley, Indiana scrambling, but they're not going to be able to keep it in. As Alexa Markley had kind of fallen behind to Hannah and Merzik and riding the hot hands of those two, she now picks up her seventh kill.
Yeah, I was going to say, you know, got off to a hot start, Markley. Had about five kills, was, I believe, tied with Merzik at one point. And with this incredible third set from Jess Merzik, the Michigan transfer. Mentioned kind of falling behind a little bit, but still making a big impact offensively. Seven kills now on the night.
Good serve from Penn State. Alonzo Corcellis gets the point with the tip of the net. Alonzo Corcellis will go back to serve here for Indiana. Still no lead changes in this match, as Jacob has alluded to throughout this third set. This has been the closest it's been, though. Nice read by Gary on the dump from Podraza. Markley ran into a wall. Double block for Cole Heed and Hayworth, and Indiana's within two.
Yeah, Cole Heed came into this match 13th all-time in blocks for Indiana. Creeping closer and closer up that list. Just one on the day so far. That one right there.
Cole Heed, one of the best players in Indiana volleyball history, 9th in hitting percentage with .308 all time. The 14th player in program history to eclipse over 300 career blocks. Came into the night with 49 on the season. Trammell through the middle, tipped by Cole Heaton, kept alive. The back row swing from Alonzo Corcellis is denied at the net by Trammell and Markley.
And that time works out for Penn State. We've seen that now quite a few times where Indiana just creeps all the way up towards the net, leaving a lot of open space on that back end. Many lines able to capitalize on their opportunity there.
Penn State the first to 20 here in the third set. Up 20-17. Podraza is back to serve for the Nittany Lions. Cameron Hanna was a few steps away from diving into the stands there to keep that one in play, but Savannah Colheed, another kill for her. Her fifth, on the night. She's back to serve. The set over to Hannah off the block. A one-handed save by Lopez. It's floated back over. Penn State now comes into its offense. Hannah again cross court. It's Colheed. Hannah one more time. A roll shot tipped up. Saris dives in and it's floated back over. Hannah again. And this time, there's no coming back here for Indiana. Fourth time's the charm for Cameron Hannah in that rally. And that's 11 kills for her on the night.
Yeah, unbelievable rally, unbelievable effort from both sides. Great job by Kelly Rammelsberg early on there, as there was a loose ball that went over the net. And Alexa Markley's eyes kind of lit up. She swung at it once, and Rammelsberg able to get all the way over, jump up and block it, and there she is again with a nice soft touch. Get the point for the Hoosiers.
She's been so effective on the slide throughout the night. Penn State read it. They got the double block up quickly. And Rammelsberg with a nice adjustment in midair. Ties Avery Tatum for a team-high 8 kills. There's Merzik right down the line and into the corner.
And once again, Cameron Haber is on the serve. Another great, powerful serve. Nothing wrong with it so far, but the Nittany Lions done an excellent job combating that. Something we talked a lot about in the pregame show. It'd be a big impact. So far, hasn't really been quite that.
Jillian Grimes nearly picks up an ace. Holland through the middle. Grimes diving in. Another great rally between these two. Here's Saris, and she ends it there with a nice kill into the back row. And Maddie Saris set to send it over. There's Hannah off the block. And Camera Hannah brings Penn State 2 points away from taking this third set. And now we're seeing Maddie Bilinovic coming to serve here for Penn State. Was the libero last season, and Jillian Grimes is coming to her own in her sophomore year. Bilinovic looking to take advantage of an opportunity here. And she does just that. Off the bench and picks up the ace.
Bilinovic, the senior libero. Had a big impact on this program for quite a few years now. Kind of lost that starting job. Jillian Grimes has emerged, but still a high impact player when she gets her opportunities. Big service ace there.
Penn State on set point here in the third set. Well, Novick got there initially. Podraza tried to keep it alive. But Indiana keeps this set going.
Number 32, Ramsey Gary, back to serve for the Hoosiers. 20 points, serving 24. This is set point.
Set point number two upcoming. As Rackhawk comes alive here. Ramsey Gary's to serve. Here's Merzik. Everyone knew where it was going. And Merzik puts it down for her 16th kill of the night as Penn State, after dropping set one, has come back to take the last two sets. There's one set away from picking up their seventh straight win.
And who else but Jess Merzik to end the set there. Just an absolutely outstanding performance from her. Ended set number two and set number three as well. We now head to set number four. It's been an exciting one so far. I don't think a lot of people expected this one to go to four sets. And that third set, the closest one so far. Should make for an exciting fourth frame coming up.
Penn State looking to close it out here in set four when we return on Big Ten Plus.
For all your Penn State gear, visit the Penn State bookstore. And when you need a break or a place to study, check out the Penn State Bookstore Cafe. The Penn State Bookstore, the official bookstore of Penn State Athletics. Your 14th-ranked Mini Lions continue to play tomorrow when they host Big Ten opponent, the Ohio State Buckeyes. We are also continuing our alumni weekend as we honor the 15-year anniversary of our 2008 NCAA National Championship team. Join us for another match filled with memories and celebrations with our alumni. We will honor the 2008 NCAA National Championship team between sets 2 and 3. First serve is slated for 6:30 p.m. Join us for a great night of volleyball. Tickets are available now at www.ticketmaster.com/netstate. We are...
Back here at Rec Hall, Penn State with a 2-1 set lead. After dropping set one, their offense has turned the corner here over the last two sets. You see it in set two, complete domination. Set three, a bit more back and forth. But that offensive change, they struggled hitting below 100 in set one. But now you look over these last two sets, Jacob, their offense has been firing on all cylinders.
Yeah, and they really did improve on everything that they were making mistakes with in that first set. The cohesion you talked about earlier, just not a lot of contributions throughout their entire lineup, but Jess Merzick starting to really come alive. Cameron Hanna also an incredible second set. Just those two transfers really being the focal points of this offense for Penn State, but also Alexa Markley coming down the line, also the sophomore playing great so far, and a lot of great blocks throughout the lineup as well. Allie Holland, 7 total blocks, Cameron Hanna, 5, as well as 4 for Taylor Trammell. Great defense, turning into great offense for the Nittany Lions, really contributed to this 2-1 match lead.
Penn State in set two nearly hit 600 at 591, and then that last third set they hit 214. For Indiana, they were up near 400 in set one. Overall in the match, they've dropped down to 138, and there you see that set-by-set hitting percentage. I mean, that second set, it tells a story on why it was such a big win for Penn State, and that third set's the closest it's been.
And it really follows exactly what each score turned out to be. You know, that first set, Indiana, was pretty dominant throughout. Not quite as dominant, obviously, as that second set from Penn State, where they won 25-9 in the third set you mentioned, Matt. Closest one so far, 25-21 finish. Still no ties or lead changes, but Indiana keeping it really close there. See if they can carry that momentum over into this fourth set.
And you've touched on that blocking ability for Penn State. 13 total blocks for this team. 4 for just Indiana. Allie Holland has been at the center of that with 7 total blocks on the night. Her offense hasn't been there, but one of the best blockers, not only in the Big Ten, but also the country, and a cornerstone piece of this Penn State defense.
She's made a real impact defensively. You would maybe expect more than just one kill from her so far, but she has still provided those points on the defensive end. Those 7 blocks have been key for this Penn State turnaround after dropping that first set.
There's Angelina Stark, getting ready to get set 4 underway. Just in front of her, you can't see her fully in screen, but Mackpo draws the center. The setter. She's been simply exceptional tonight. Huge part of why this Penn State offense has gotten going. And now Indiana here, just like they started set one, they start off set 4 with a point.
Number 32, fancy getting back. Sorry, Matt, to interrupt you, but another trend through those first three sets. Team that scored first ended up winning each set, so they started here for Indiana.
That's exactly where I was going to go to.
Very nice thing alike.
They do indeed. Here's Merzick. Blocked. And it stays in play. Indiana. Early 2 points. Still no ties, no lead changes, as Jacob alluded to as we came out of the break. You're just joining us, Matt Scalzo alongside Jacob Schnurr. The first three sets, we've seen whoever took the set got out to a large lead rather quickly, and it's Indiana doing it in set 4.
Yeah, past two sets, 5-0 start for Penn State, then a 4-0 start for Penn State. Now 3-0 Indiana start to gain momentum.
There's Merzick, and Penn State's on the board with her 17th kill. Gets it off the double block of Indiana.
Not a big change from that first set. You know, I talked about it a lot throughout that opening frame. Indiana not really allowing Penn State to gain any momentum in terms of, you know, getting on a rally and starting to score multiple points in a row. Past two sets, been a completely different story. A lot of big runs for this Penn State offense. Maybe something that Indiana might want to key in on here in this set.
And there's Candela. Alonzo Corcellis with another kill for herself. That's her eighth kill. Merzick denied there. It's Hayworth all by herself.
Double one. Point. Five.
And a quick timeout here for Katie Schumacher Colley in Penn State as they've gotten out into that early lead in set two and set three, but Indiana, like they did in set one, off to a big lead here to begin set four. We'll step aside and begin 10 plus.
Please stand and be recognized for all of your work in helping us build this great program. Thank you, Nindy Lyons.
Inside historic rec hall, Matt Scalzo alongside Jacob Schmer. Thanks for joining us here on a beautiful Friday night in Happy Valley. Indiana took set one. Penn State responded with the next two, and now the Hoosiers off to an early lead here in set four, trying to take us to the fifth set. Matt, Jacob, Indiana, they only beat Penn State once all time, and never here at rec hall. They're giving them all they got here right now.
And last time they even won a set at rec hall before today was 2021. Now already up to one set victory in that opening frame. Up 5-1 here. These early portions of these sets have really set the tone for the entire match so far. Seen in each one so far, Indiana, you mentioned. Off to a hot start here. We'll see if they can keep it up.
Avery Tatum gets us going out of the timeout. Merzick, the cross-court swing. And off the double block of Holland and Hannah, it's Alonzo Corcellis picking up her ninth kill, tying a team high with Tatum and Rammelsberg. Back set to Hannah, just taps it over, and a beautiful dig from Ramsey Gary, but Indiana on the other end. Point. Keep the play.
Yeah, unfortunate hit out of play there, but you see right there, the big key for Indiana so far early in the set is that defense has been playing at a really high level so far early here. Penn State got that lead in large part because of how outstanding their defense has been, especially with Allie Holland getting those seven blocks right at the net. Indiana flying around the court right now, playing much better defensively than they did in those previous two.
Maddie Bilanovic back in. She had the serve. Merzick. That's more like it for Penn State. And Indiana's blocking party had come on full display here in the early stages of set four. Had just four blocks total through the first three. Had two in the early portion here. Bilanovic, a nice dig. Odraza one-on-one with Alonzo Corcellis. And it's just off her hands.
Yeah, Odraza unhappy with herself there. Had an opportunity, had a big block. Just a little bit off to the left. Flicks off her hand, out of bounds, and another Indiana point as they pull away here early.
Overpass from Grimes. Indiana on the other end, stretching its lead up to five.
Talked about a little bit at the end of that third set, you know, able to carry over, or excuse me, able to forget about that second set pretty quickly. Had a really close effort in set number three. Seeing Indiana, if they could potentially carry that momentum into set number four to make it a little bit closer, and so far they've done just that.
Mrzyk denied by Savannah Colheed. Aylworth was over there as well. We've seen that resurgence here from Indiana like we saw in set number one.
And now 98 total matches of experience in Savannah Colheed's career. One of the true veterans and leaders for this Hoosiers team. As you mentioned before, Matt, one of the best players in program history.
And a net violation there against Podraza at Penn State. Makes it a big lead here for Indiana, and seeing some changes here. Zoe Weatherington comes in on the outside. Also a change at that center position, Allie Van Ekren. From Creighton.
Attack. Point.
That
Indiana.
Attack from Mrzyk.
11, sorry, 3.
Yeah, just about whatever can go wrong for Penn State has gone wrong so far. Indiana, exactly what they should be doing, capitalizing on those mistakes. Playing clean volleyball as they did in that opening set.
There's Allie Holland getting in on the offensive action. Picks up a kill. Pickballed around Indiana until it was four touches.
Number nine, Jess Mrzyk, back to serve for your Indy Lions. Four, serving 11.
Looks like Cameron Hayworth having a quick word with the referee. Nothing coming of it.
7-point lead here for Indiana over Penn State. On cross court, it's Colheed, and it splits between Mrzyk and Van Ekren.
Colheed back to
short experience for Van Ekren here as Podraza will come back in.
Perfect placement on that attack, as you mentioned, splitting right in between them. On that soft spot, threading the needle. So Mrzyk complained a bit about wet spot on the court. They get that cleaned up. See if that improves anything on the defensive end for the Nittany Lions.
Here's Mrzyk from the back row. Kept up by Colheed. Here's Markley off the block. Rammelsberg with a nice bump. And through the double block goes Saris. Anything and everything in favor of Indiana.
And just really flipping the script from that third set. Talked a lot about those blocks for Penn State, how much of an impact that's made, and not really getting anything going here in that category so far. Hoosiers finding all the holes in Penn State's defense.
There's a back set from Podraza Holland. Nice fist bump from the setter.
Back to serve
up to 3 kills for her now. Penn State has gone on runs throughout the season. This is one of those points where you need them to do that. Holland and Trammell, both the middles, keeping it alive as a long free ball is sent over by Mrzyk. And the slide from Rammelsberg. Brings the lead back up to 9 for Indiana.
Points, Indiana. Number 10, Cameron Hayward, back to serve for the Hoosiers. 14-5.
Another service attempt here coming for Cameron Hayworth. Still yet to enter the service ace category on the night.
Nice receive by Merzik. Start with the pushover. Bodraza. Nice dig from Milanovic. Trammell through the middle. Trammell again. And there's Hayworth once more. Tatum down the line, finds the corner.
Avery Tatum was leading this Hoosiers team in kills for quite a while. Got passed by Rammelsberg and Alonzo Corsellis. Now back at 10. All three of those players tied in double digits.
Fans, timeout from Penn State as Indiana in full force here at set number 4, a 15-5 lead, looking to send it to 5 sets. We'll find out when we return at Penn State.
At www.ticketmaster.com/Penn State. We are.
Back here at Rec Hall, Indiana up 15-5 and looking to keep their momentum going. Another road trip on tap for them tomorrow. They'll head to College Park to take on the Maryland Terrapins. And for them, they also got Purdue and Michigan coming up in the next weekends there. They've faced the two top teams in the Big Ten. Now they're taking on the third here tonight. Fell to Nebraska and Wisconsin in prior weeks, and there's the rest of the matchup. A couple of dates with number 19 Purdue and number 24 Ohio State later down the road. Meanwhile, for Penn State, they'll see the 24th ranked Buckeyes here tomorrow night. A huge top 25 matchup. Penn State 1-3 in Big Ten ranked matchups this season. Picked up the top 25 win over Western Kentucky early in the year. Also got Nebraska on the horizon, and Angelina Stark out of the timeout. Get some energy back in this crowd with a nice kill.
And it should be interesting to see how this Big Ten Conference plays out as we get more into the heat of this interconference play. Mentioned that Ohio State matchup tomorrow coming for Penn State here in Rec Hall. A lot about how dominant this team has been in their home building, but so far tonight, struggling against an unranked Indiana team, definitely going to face a different beast tomorrow in the Buckeyes.
Back-to-back points here for Penn State in a timeout. It's Tatum's swing goes in on that.
7,
15. Draws the one back to serve. She's nearing a double-double, has 34 assists and 9 digs. Stark, the solo block on Tatum.
Angelina Stark,
and a quick timeout here as Penn State has come out of timeout on a 3-0 run, and Steve Aird will take a timeout on Indiana's side as Penn State within 7, back after the break. We're back here at Rec Hall, Penn State. Trailing by 7, and we'll take a look around the conference here and how this past week has fared. This will be a notable name at the top there, Mac Potraza, Coach Setter of the Week, along with Berg and Riley from Nebraska. Both were outstanding this week. Merritt Beeson, the outside hitter, offensive player of the week, and Carter Booth out of Wisconsin was defensive player of the week. They gave 13 blocks. Wins against Ohio State and Michigan.
Not surprising to see two Nebraska players on there. Mentioned the number two team in the country. They've been absolutely outstanding. And good job by Mac Podraza so far. Struggled a bit in this set currently, but been outstanding so far in her first season with Penn State, the Ohio State transfer. We get a crack at her old team tomorrow night. It should be exciting to see how she builds upon this incredible season for the Nittany Lions so far.
13th time in her career that Podraza has picked up Big Ten Center of the Week honors. Big Ten Setter of the Year in 2022 with the Buckeyes. She's back to serve here as Penn State on a 3-0 run currently. Now the timeout, here's Indiana. And it's Angelina Stark capitalizing again. On the overpass, she's got two kills and has really been a back row player. But Katie Schumacher-Cawley looking for a spark. Slot Stark in the front row, and she's got a pair of kills.
We've seen quite a few times tonight that the team that calls a timeout comes out and immediately gets a quick point, is able to turn the momentum a little bit. There, Penn State doing a good job maintaining their momentum from before the timeout. Getting a big kill there. Close the gap even more.
Here comes Hannah, and she's blocked by Tatum.
Blocked by Avery Tatum.
Indiana so far in this set looking a lot like Penn State did in those two previous sets, connecting on a lot of attacks but also playing outstanding defense right at the net. Big block there by Avery Tatum.
That looked like a chance for Penn State to really inject some life into this rec hall crowd on that last rally. Tatum, as she's done all night long. Indiana, that offense. Service error in Penn State. Eclipses the 10-point line.
Angelina Stark is back to serve here with the Lions. This is 10, serving 16.
Stark back to serve here for Penn State. Set through the middle, it's Rammelsberg. Off the fingertips of Trammell.
Number 32.
And he's just trading points back and forth. Really hard for Penn State to close the gap that way. Indiana more than happy with that, however, getting that 7-point lead.
Nice up by Gosnell in the back row, and off the block of Hannah, it's Alonzo Gorselis. As Indiana surges ahead once again, back-to-back points. Serve, she's been outstanding. Trammell down the middle, and Gary with a nice dig, but an illegal attack from Alonzo Corsellis.
Trammell, point.
As Allie Holland checks back in for the Nittany Lions, she's made a huge impact. We talked about her quite a bit. Now this third set getting a little bit out of reach for Penn State. They need someone to provide a spark.
Avery Tatum. She's had the answer here against Penn State. Now tied with Rammelsberg and Alonzo Corsellis at 11 kills at the top of that Indiana chart. Merzik looking to go cross court. Gets a tip at the net. Looks like we might be getting our first challenge of the night from Steve Aird. He's going to challenge whether or not there was a tip at the net on that swing.
Indiana has challenged the previous play for a touch at the net.
Couldn't
quite tell from our perspective here. Can hear a sound. See the replay here. Doesn't look like anyone made contact with it. Maybe if anything, scraping a fingertip there, but there's a good chance this one gets overturned.
And so the other creature is there.
I believe it's Rambelsburg.
I think you're right there.
It doesn't deflect Rambelsburg's fingertips. Can you tell just in the replay whether or not it does?
And the point is overturned. It was Colheed and Hayworth that were up there, but didn't catch either of their fingers. Point goes to Indiana. And now they're the first to 20, up by 9.
Looks like a good call there. Didn't really see it touch anyone's fingertips. I think it did just go straight over the hands. Referee agreed. Now Indiana the first to 20. In this fourth set.
We're set to get back underway here out of the review. Tatum still back to serve Indiana. And her serve goes long.
Service error.
Maddie Bilinovic will come in to serve here for Cameron Hammond. Number two,
Maddie Bilinovic, back to serve here in the Lions. This is 12.
There's a huge block for Penn State. Double block for Merzick and Holland. Gives this crowd some life.
Yeah, good job by Merzick to get over there, get her hands up, get that block. Penn State still trailing by 7, though. Once again, similar to that first set, not able to really put together a run of points and gain any momentum. Indiana has done a great job preventing that. And right there, immediately, another point.
It's Candela Alonso Corcellis. She's had the hot hand all night with Indiana. That's her 12th kill. Has 13 digs along to go along with that. The only Hoosier with a double-double currently. Holland on the slide. It's Lopez that's there, but comes back over the net and out of play.
Going back to Candela Alonso Corcellis, not only 12 kills on the night, also 122 now on the season, second best on this team. Number one in that category on the season would be Maddie Saris. Only 6 tonight, a little bit of a quiet night from her. She swings one there, but great night from Alonso Corcellis, Avery Tatum, and Kaylee Rambelsburg, all in double-digit kills.
Nice dig from Bilinovic. Stark on the other end. There was a tip.
Two challenges remaining. For head coach Steve Aird, we'll see if he opts to use another one.
Doesn't look like he will. Your kill leaders for Penn State, Merzick, Hannah, and Markley. Stark's got 3. Bilinovic, another nice dig there, but just hit awkwardly into the bottom of the net, made it tough for Potraz to get that second pass. Indiana. 3 points to points away from forcing a decisive fifth set here on a Friday night in Happy Valley. Full heed to serve. Here's Holland, cross court. Alonzo Corcellis is there, and then through the middle is Kaylee Rammelsberg.
23.
Bring Indiana just one step closer. Stark looking to go cross court, can't find the line, and Indiana moves to set point here in set number four.
She's done a great job silencing this rec hall crowd. They're really getting into it these past two sets. As Penn State kind of dominated in sets two and three, but Indiana doing a great job bouncing back on the verge of forcing that fifth set.
That serve goes into the net. And so we'll move to set point number two here in the fourth set. 24-16 lead for Indiana. Taylor Trammell comes back in. Allie Holland back to serve for Penn State. Milanovic diving in. Stark on the roll shot. We'll go another point.
Angelina Stark. Point. Penn State.
Lions starting to put a few things together here at the end of this. Or as we near the end of this fourth set. Hoping for a miracle, but even if they can't pull this off, good to at least get potentially some momentum going for that fifth and final set. We saw Indiana in that set number three. It came all the way back at the end, made it a close 25-21 finish. Penn State won, but that 4-point deficit, closest we've seen yet in any of these sets so far, has parlayed into a great fourth set here for them.
Momentum keeps on going here for Penn State. A little bit of a run after the service ace. That's going to prompt the timeout from Indiana. A 4-0 run and a service ace for Allie Holland. Makes it 24-19. We'll step aside here, Penn State, trying to create some magic late here in the fourth set. Here at Rep Call in set number four. It's a 24-19 Indiana lead. The Hoosiers trying to force a decisive fifth set. They haven't gone to five sets against Penn State in quite some time, and the Hoosiers only got one win all time against Penn State, 60-1. Penn State has dominated the series, and no wins at Rec Call for Indiana. Just need one more point to force a fifth set, but Penn State on a 4-0 run here. Trying to come back from a huge deficit. No room for error here in the fourth set. Allie Holland coming off a service ace and coming out of the Indiana timeout gets us going once again. Pedraza just sets it over. Hayworth ends it. Saw the opening of the back row.
Indiana takes set number four by a score of 25.
And Indiana takes set number four, 25-19.
Excellent initial dig there by Merzig to keep it alive. And that coach draws it, just sending that three ball over, allowing Rich to set up. We talked a bit about it before, Cameron Hayworth. Not your usual setter, has that big swing, really aggressive on the attack. Shows it off there to end the set number four.
We're We're going to five sets here in Happy Valley. The fifth and final set. It all comes down to this when we return here on Big Ten Plus. And we're heading to a fifth set for the first time ever between these two teams. Matt Scalzo alongside Jacob Schnurr. Jacob, we've touched on the series history throughout it all. 60-1 Penn State all time against Indiana, 31-0 all time here at Rec Hall. And in that fourth set, we saw a complete change of pace from what we saw in the two sets prior. Penn State's hitting percentage went down to 0-29 in that fourth set. Indiana back up near that 300 mark, and that's why you see these stats through the four sets so even.
Yeah, it's been a really even back and forth match so far. So having that second set where Penn State really dominated from start to finish, every other set has been really close. These two teams have put on a great performance, each great effort. Indiana, a chance to make history. You mentioned that record at home, in Rec Hall. Never have a victory here. Big chance to get there first if you head into set number five. Good strong finish there. Penn State also, though, started to gain some momentum at the end of that fourth set. Almost pulled off kind of a little bit of a miracle comeback. Didn't quite get there, though, didn't hit that 20-point mark, but a good effort to finish. You saw Indiana did the same kind of thing at the end of set number three, making it 25-21. Still ended up losing that set, obviously. But that momentum carried over into the next set. We'll see if Penn State can do the same or if Indiana can hold that lead.
You look at these two teams. Who are a player on either side that you're going for in this fifth set?
Yeah, I mean, I think for Penn State, it's got to be Jess Merzick. She's been absolutely dominant so far tonight, leading the Nittany Lions with 18 kills. Was incredible in that third set, really from start to finish dominated. Also, Cameron Hanna on that side has been a little bit quiet since set number two, but if she could come out and play a little bit better in this set, that'd be big for Penn State. On the Indiana side, they have three players in double-digit kills, the top one being Alonzo Corcellos with 12, Avery Tatum and Kaylee Rammelsberg also have 11 each. I think Alonzo Corcellos is probably the player to look at, just as I mentioned, leading the team. But also, Maddie Saris leads this team in kills on the season, only 6 tonight. See if she can step up in this fifth and final set.
As I said, coming out of the break, 5 sets between Penn State and Indiana. Never seen it before. But here on October 6th, we're seeing it here. Penn State has won 20 straight matches against Indiana, the last Indiana win, and only Indiana win, October 9th, 2010, in Bloomington. And set five starts out with a service error, and if you've picked up on any trends through the first four sets, Jacob will let you know that whoever has scored the first point has gone on to win the set, as there has been 0 ties and 0 lead changes through any of the sets.
Yeah, and those opening points have really managed to set the tone for each and every set so far.
And for the first time tonight, there is a tie as Rammelsberg goes right through the middle.
No better time for things to change when the stakes are the highest in this fifth set, Matt.
To serve, Ramsey Gary just floats it over. The back set to Hanna, blocked and covered by Penn State. Back set to Tatum, and it's off the block of Merzick. So there's your first lead change along with your first tie. Back set to Hanna. And there's another kill for Cameron Hanna. Jacob, you alluded to it, how big it would be to get her going, and she does just that.
Yeah, Cameron Hanna, talked about her a lot earlier, had an incredible second set. then kind of started to die off a little bit in terms of kills. There gets her 13th now in the night. She steps off the court for the time being, but going to be a big player down the stretch if Penn State wants to have a chance to close this one out.
Block goes into the pin here near the scorer's table, and Indiana jumps back on top.
So we never saw a tie or a lead change heading into this set. We're now seeing two ties. Indiana back with the lead.
Holland on the slide, just mistimes it. And now Indiana with a big lead. Well, I say big, it's only two, but it seems that number one team really starts to find some momentum. They string together a few more points. We'll see if Penn State's got an answer here. And it's not the way they drew it up, but Allie Holland will take that point.
Allie Holland, that's only her fifth assist on the season. Not really known for that aspect of her game, but it's a nice little pass there. Kind of trailed away from the intended teammate. Still works out, gets that third point.
Not sure Merzik even caught a piece of it. As Grimes, the perfect spot for a nice dig. Here comes Stark on the offensive end. What an emergence Angelina Stark has been here. Late in this match, even in that fourth set, now here in the fifth, she's tied it at four.
That time, perfectly in rhythm. Great pass there on the back end by Jess Merzik right to Stark. Clean swing. And yet another tie, third of this set.
Indiana challenging that last point, looking for a net violation. It's the second time we've seen a challenge come from the Hoosiers. They were successful in their first, getting a call reversed.
They're saying Stark.
At least from that point, or that swing from Stark, I don't see anything that stands out unless you do. Unless it came on a prior swing or attack in that rally.
Yeah, it looks to be pretty clear cut, as you said, seeing from a different angle here. Sure what the issue could be. In terms of these replays, it looks like it's a pretty good bet that Indiana will end up losing their second challenge.
Long look here at the scorer's table. They're looking to see if at any point someone made contact with the net throughout that rally. And the wave starting to get going here at Rec Hall, keeping the fans active here in a do or die fifth set.
The wave gets going, Matt. Are you a fan of the wave celebration?
Yeah, I'm personally okay with it. I don't really lean either way if I love it or if I hate it.
It's a fairly controversial celebration,
I
realize. I feel like people that are consider themselves diehard sports fans may not like it for whatever reason. I'm not really quite sure why, but I've definitely seen some dislike of the wave celebration.
I'm not opposed to it, especially when you get into these points where you're looking at practically any point during a rally where there might have been a net violation and the review takes a little longer. anything to keep your fans engaged, I feel like, is the best way to go about it. It's stayed pretty strong here.
It's still going. And, yeah, especially you said keep the fans engaged during this fairly long challenge. It's taking quite a while for the referee to review this. Look at the replay once again. See if anyone at any point made contact with that net. Potentially Stark on the follow through, if anything, but after all that, they will keep the point in Penn State's favor.
After all that, it basically turned into a mini timeout for both teams. See what changes here as we're knotted at four. Here in the fifth set, Jess Merzik is the one back to serve. And there was a touch on that attack for Indiana. They'll jump back in front. As was Alonzo Corcellis picking up her 14th kill.
Penn State two times now. They've tied this set, still not able to pull off the lead change. It's eluded them all night.
Holland blocked at the net by Saris. Alonzo Corcellis continues to serve. There's the set to Stark. And Angelina Stark has found her mojo once again on that outside. Picks up her fourth kill, or excuse me, her sixth kill. Tapped over. Holland is there. Over to Stark once more. And a net violation against Indiana ties it at six.
Yet another tie. Mentioned earlier, Penn State tied it quite a few times in this set. Still have not been able to get over that hump and take the lead. You talked about it a little bit earlier also, Matt. You know, each time that one of these teams start to get a little bit of a lead so far, being able to maintain it. Indiana has had a two-point lead quite a few times now. Penn State doing a good job fighting back. Big opportunity now with Allie Holland serving.
A set over to Saris. Tipped up. Here's Stark. Hayworth takes it herself, but Merzik's right there. Stark one more time. Angelina Stark, the late heroics. And Penn State with that elusive lead change here in the fifth set.
I feel like it's been a different player for each team kind of stepping up in each set. So far in this one, it's been Angelina Stark. And really interesting to see how Katie Schumacher-Cawley, Penn State's head coach, has maneuvered this lineup a bit, trying to find a spark. Angelina Stark has been moved all over the place from the back row to the front, doing just about everything for this Penn State team. The one constant has been Jess Merzik, but even as we see Maddie Bielanovic out on the floor, we haven't seen her too much tonight.
Stark goes into the crowd for the save. But Maddie Saris has the answer on the other end. This place feels like at any point, Ruth might leave Rec Hall.
Obviously, Penn State didn't get the point there, but another just outstanding play by Angelina Stark, the hustle to dive into the stands, one hand right on the money to Mac Pedraza. Maddie Saris, great job by her stepping up. We talked about she leads this team in kills on the season, but has had a little bit of a quiet night. She sends it out of bounds there.
Hitting error there, and Penn State the first to 8 points. They'll switch sides here. About as close as you can make it here through the fifth set. Not a timeout, just quick little change You reach that halfway point. The two teams switch sides, make it as even as possible. Not sure how even it is with a home court advantage like Penn State has. That call faithful, starting to get on their feet, starting to get a little louder as this one moves along. Mac Pedraza heads back to the service line. And we're back underway. Rammelsberg on the slide. Pedraza comes diving in. Rammelsberg once again. Pedraza's there. It's floated back over. And Saris avenges her miscue from a point ago. Gets it off the block of Trammell and knots it up at 8.
And now 2 kills for Saris here in this set. Great job by Trammell. Almost got over there for the block, but just couldn't quite knock it over the net on the other way. Indiana tying it up once again. What a way to play out this final set here, Matt.
Hayworth, she's been so effective with her serves, hasn't gotten an ace, but there she gets an error. And Penn State goes back in front. Rammelsberg through the middle, just gets enough of it. This is what Big Ten volleyball is all about. Any given night, a team can push you towards the brink. Indiana trying to persevere through the sound here inside a rec hall. Kenzie Daphne back to serve.
Fans making an impact here in rec hall, Matt. Getting really loud, riled up. Kenzie Daphne, the service error now. 10 service errors on the night for the Hoosiers.
Penn State the first to 10 here in the fifth set. Set over to Mrzek. Alonzo Corcellis, a nice dig. Cameron Hanna. What a huge point. A long rally. And Hannah, who had fallen quiet in that third set, even in that fourth, gives Penn State and this rec hall crowd huge life. 4 points away from taking the fifth set. We'll step aside as Indiana takes a timeout here in set 5. At Rec Hall, reminder that there's no plus like home on Big Ten Plus. In addition to live games, your subscription includes exclusive access to Big Ten Network's library of classic games, award-winning original programming, and specially curated digital channels that highlight your favorite Big Ten school 24/7. Explore all that Big Ten Plus has to offer on the app or at BigTenPlus.com. You've been watching this one on Big Ten Plus. You've been in for a treat. 5 sets between Penn State and Indiana. The Hoosiers looking for their first win ever at Rec Hall and second all time against Penn State. They took set 1. Penn State responded with the next 2 sets. And then the Hoosiers in set 4 came back to force set 5. And this has been the closest it's been here in the fifth and final set. We've seen ties. We've seen lead changes for the first time tonight. And this Rec Hall crowd has made a difference.
Just an excellent fight from both these teams. Really couldn't script it any better than this in the fifth set. 11-9 score.
back and forth action. You've had offense, you've had defense, you've had service aces, you've had just about everything in this match so far. All coming down to this.
We even had a libero get a kill in Ramsey Gary, who's back to serve for Indiana. Here's Hannah, the tap over.
Great job by Cameron Hannah. Talked a lot about her falling a little bit quiet for a bit in this match after a great second set. Coming alive here in set number five.
Maddie Bilinovic in the serve and gets the ace. We've talked a lot about how big Angelina Stark's been down the stretch. Maddie Bilinovic, another late sub, and she's got a couple of aces as Indiana takes another timeout. Penn State 2 points away from picking up their seventh straight win, up 13-10 here in set five. I don't even know if I have to say any more words, Jacob. This crowd has been electric tonight at Rec Hall, and here in the fifth set, they're ready to see their Nittany Lions take it. They just need two more points. The energy has been unmatched, and the competition as well. Indiana pushing Penn State to its breaking point in a series that's long been dominated by the Nittany Lions. The Hoosiers trying to turn a new page, but Maddie Bilinovic, who picked up a service ace, looks to put Penn State on set point. And Alonzo Corsellis on the other end brings Indiana within two. What an outstanding night it has been for the sophomore outside hitter out of Madrid, Spain.
Crowd starts to get loud again. Now we saw it before, forced a service error.
The set to Mrzek. Penn State on set and match point.
Now this incredible crowd on their feet. They've just been absolutely electric since the start. Made a huge impact on this match.
Mrzek's got 19 kills. And here we are for set and match point. It's over! Allie Holland in there on the double block to end it for Penn State.
What a way to finish, man.
Couldn't ask for
unbelievable.
Much more.
Unbelievable match. Start to finish. Kept it close in that first set. Second set, a little bit of a dominant performance by Penn State, but right back to that close back and forth Big Ten volleyball that we know and love. And wow, what a finish. Talked about how incredible the crowd was all throughout. Right at the climax there in that fifth set, the loudest they were all night. Talked about it making a huge impact. Contributions up and down each lineup, breakout performances, just a real treat to be sitting here sideline at this one.
First five-set match of the season for Penn State. First five-set match ever against the Hoosiers. And it's hard not to talk about a storyline from this game without talking about the late resurgence of players like Angelina Stark and Maddie Bilanovic, who came up huge down the stretch. Jess Mirza, Cameron Hanna, they were outstanding as well. Can't forget Allie Holland, who on that last point picked up her ninth block of the night.
Now, you mentioned Angelina Stark. I talked a little bit about her versatility throughout the night. Katie Schumacher-Colley moving her in the back, putting her in front, moving her all over the place, doing just about everything offensively and defensively. As we see here, Jess Mirzik, 19 kills on the night, just two off of that 21 that she had last weekend. She's been absolutely outstanding all season, transferring over from Michigan, been a huge key part of this Penn State team. Just unbelievable performances up and down the lineup, like you mentioned, all those contributions. And also got to talk about Indiana. Great job by Alonzo Corsales and Rammelsberg and Avery Tatum as well.
An outstanding night for volleyball. Penn State back at home tomorrow against Ohio State at 6:30. That'll do it for tonight for our entire broadcast crew and my broadcast partner, Jacob Schnur. I'm Matt Scalzo saying so long from Rec Hall.